So now I can install MariaDB, which is a package that would probably have been installed anyway, even though it's only an optional, I think it's optional package for Qt. It's quite likely it would be used by another package as more of a main thing, main package to be installed, main database. So it says MariaDB and MySQL cannot be installed on the same system without extensive changes. I don't think MySQL is in the BLFS book anymore. I think it used to be, but it's not anymore. So we need to add in a group and a user, which are ones that are used to manage the database. Come out of this. Let's make the, let's extract it first. Have I even downloaded it? No, I haven't. No, what happened there then? Let's try it again, save link as. Oh, right, okay, QWE download. So I'll get rid of that HTML. So I need to open this up in a browser, or I could download from the FTP, but let's go through the browser. Looks like it may be that version. Right, what version do we need? 10.64 we need for to be consistent with the book. So that's not actually there. So what I'm going to do is, to make things a bit easier, just download from this FTP link, and that link should be there. I imagine that, yeah, it is. That FTP directory's got all the previous versions. So it's only 80 meg, but the download is obviously a little bit slow. Oh, it's very, very slow, this is. Right, yeah, it's just finished. So, extract the file. Now, it says here the installed size, this is the installed size of MariaDB, is 644 megabytes, but it can be reduced, as you can see, by approximately 40%. if desired, by removing the test directory after installation. So it's a shame that's not near the bottom, because the chances are you'll get down to the bottom, it's installed, you'll forget about it. So it'd be good if that could be moved, that box. Okay, so we've already added the groups and the group and the user. So let's paste in and create the build directory. Now I'm going to copy the cmake command, see what options we've got to modify that command. So embedded server on, this switch enables compiling the embedded server library needed by certain applications such as Amarok. So that's set. With extra char sets equal complex, dskip tests equals on. Okay, without server on. Use this switch if you don't want the server and would like to build a client only. So you need to add that in by the looks of it. I'm going to leave it and build the server. It could be useful. As it says, there's numerous other options for CMake, but I'm not going to modify anything that hasn't been mentioned in the book, in case I build something that's not compatible or won't work with something else in the book. So I'm going to leave it as it is, the config, and run it. Now, if you lower memory, I know from past experience that building of MariaDB can take up a lot of memory. So if you haven't got a lot of memory, you might want to consider reducing the number of threads, if that's a possibility. I can't remember the exact details, but it seems to use a lot more memory when it's building than you'd expect, so that's worth considering. Maybe run it and see if it is starting to swap, and if it is, then you know, stop it and then reduce the number of threads and rebuild. So let's start the build off and wait for it to finish. Okay, that's built after 40 minutes, so now I'm going to run the tests. Oops. So. Okay, so there's a few tests failed there. Test connected says known to fail. I don't know what the PFS is. It did seem to pause around that time. So I'm going to run the extended tests. It says 5400 tests, over 5400. 200 failed character set issues, and there's chances I may get more than that. So let's see what happens with those tests. Again, with the minus n, n for the number of threads. See how that runs. So that has finished with 1, 2, 3, 4 errors, but looks, or 5 it says there actually. One, oh yeah, MySQL dump. So I guess we could look at the logs, though I wouldn't know what to do to fix these. These are obviously the two character set ones, and these PFS ones are the ones that came up before. Not sure why that one's failed. Let's have a look at our log. So let's have a look at the PFS, for example. Okay, doesn't look like there's going to be anything there that makes much sense to me. There's nothing there I can make sense of really without spending time in it, but at least the majority run. Let's see how many actually went through. So 5,711, and it says that over 5,400 should run, so I think less than 1% chance, failure, sorry. Is pretty successful, and if this was obviously a mission critical thing, that would have to be investigated. So I'm going to install what we've got. And there's a basic configuration file to be installed here. Change the ownership, install the database and change the ownership. Okay, so I'm going to do source etc profile, rerun that. Okay, not sure why that's not worked. Let's do sudo minus e su and run that again. No, I'm not sure why that's not working. Sure, why the binary is not installing. There's a few there, so let's do my MySQL install. quite strange that that binary is not anywhere to be seen. make install again. Oh, I know why. I didn't pop D out of this directory, that's why. Oh dear. Pop D there. Sudo make install again. Right, that's better. Okay, now I should be able to go back to root, and this command should now work. That's better. Further configuration requires that the MariaDB server is running. Start the server using the following commands as a root user. So now start the server. I think that's started, is it? Yep, and then set a password for the root user, and this is the root user of the database. Now shut down the server. Put the password in you've just created. And then I need to install the boot script so that it starts up automatically. Make install MySQL. MySQL, and then I can start it. And that's it running in the background. So that's MariaDB complete. That's chapter 22. And I've got a note next to this saying then reinstall Cyrus-Sazzle. So I'm going to do that now. Cyrus-Sazzle. So is that part of this in any way? No, it's not. So what I need to do is to close that down and load up Cyrus-Sazzle. Okay, that's what it's for. It's to rebuild this after MariaDB has been installed, by the looks of it. So let me first of all tidy up the build. Extract Cyrus-Sazzle. It, well, it probably doesn't matter. It says to fix a build failure if Sphinx or DocuTools is installed. Oh, well, yes, it does matter because we've got DocuTools. Then build this. Let's copy these options. Oops, and I don't want to do that. And just check what we've got here. So LDAP, I think I've got that installed, but it's not installed to run. I think it was just purely to get a dependency fulfilled. I'll add in Java support. And I think that's all I need to add in. What was it happening? LDAP. It was an optional one. I guess I could stick it in. build it. Yeah, there's some character set things there that look a bit strange. So time make minus J1. Okay, that's rebuilt, let's reinstall now. And that's complete. And that's installed again, so Cyrus Sazzle. Chapter 4. Right, I didn't have a note against that, it was just against MariaDB, so it was obviously something that affected MariaDB. So I can shut that one down now, and it looks like we're finally back onto Qt, so I'm just going to check these dependencies again. So KD frameworks, that's something I'm going to reinstall Falkon for. Falkon doesn't take too long. I haven't built KDE yet, so that's a rebuild for KDE Frameworks. So we've got one dependency there for Qt Web Engine, but looks fit. I think Node.js might be installed, but we'll check that. So MariaDB, ProgressQL, not going to install. So yeah, it looks like we're ready to reinstall Qt again. Now, what I wanted to do was to reinstall this in a separate directory. So obviously if I install into Qt5, then it could affect what's already here, so what's already installed. Because it says sometimes installation paths are hard-coded into installation files. This is the reason why opt-qt5 uses installation prefix instead of opt-qt5.152. It then says you can change the symlink, but the point is if that might be hard-coded, then the system is always looking at that directory and therefore it must always point at something valid, otherwise you can't use anything that uses Qt5. So this is what I'm concerned about. Just looking at Qt, I need to check these other dependencies, because what I'm going to try and do is install these without having to use Falkon and just flick between the tabs. So I need to check. See, Qt5 will be installed, but I need to check that these are installed. Let's have a look at this one, Chapter 9. This is Node.js. Yep, that is installed, so that was just purely the link that's not been activated. And the other one's Pipewire. LibEvent, I'm sure there was something about that one. Let me have a look at Pipewire first. So this is 42. Right, yeah, this hasn't been installed, but it looks like all the dependencies are installed. So I can get this one in. And looks like I might be able to add in. Docs is true for HTML. and it says men. True as well, so this might work. There's something there called XML to men, so it may fail with this switch, but I'll try it and see what happens. Oh, I didn't put the docs right. I need to remove this make build and cd build, and I forgot to put in the hyphen in front of the docs equals true. Right, so value true of type string for combo action build documentation, all the choices possible are enabled, disabled, or auto. Okay, so the book obviously needs to be updated to reflect that. So let's try that one. And looks like this one's the same as well. Right, so docstring's not been found. I'm going to guess that's the last one. It looks like it's same for both of them. I'll change this to man and see if I get the same error or any other error. Otherwise, it means I just can't build this documentation. No, yeah, that's what I said. The XML to man looked like it might have been a dependency. So I'll just have to leave these two off. Okay, so ninja to build it. And just scrolling back, you can see there's a few things that I'll just stop at a moment. Have not been set, but there's nothing unexpected there, so that's okay. Okay, let's run some tests, and they've all passed, so I'm going to install this now. And it's complete. So that's chapter 42, Pipewire. Shut that down. I just want to check this lib event now. Something in the back of my mind telling me that I thought there was something else to do with this for some reason. And that doesn't look to be the case, so that's all okay.